एनाटॉमी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स, एनाटॉमी स्टडी ऑफ इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर और इंटरनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट, डील्स विथ सेक्शनल व्यू ऑफ पार्ट्स ऑफ प्लांट अंडर माइक्रोस्कोप. इन प्लांट एनाटॉमी वी स्पेशली डील विथ स्टडी ऑफ टिश्यूज एंड इंटरनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्लांट ऑर्गन्स, मेनली रूट, स्टेम एंड लीफ. एनाटॉमी हेल्प अस टू अंडरस्टैंड द फिजियोलॉजी दैट इज फंक्शंस ऑफ प्लांट ऑर्गन. फादर ऑफ प्लांट एनाटॉमी नेहमिया ग्रीव एंड ग्रीव. स्टडी ऑफ टिश्यूज कॉल्ड हिस्टोलॉजी. फादर ऑफ हिस्टोलॉजी मार्सेलो मेल्पिघी. टिश्यू रिप्रेजेंट्स ग्रुप ऑफ सिमिलर और डिसिमिलर सेल्स विच आर कोऑर्डिनेटेड और कॉपरेटिंग विथ ईच अदर, परफॉर्मिंग सिंगल फंक्शन और सेट ऑफ फंक्शंस, एंड ऑल द सेल्स हैव सेम ओरिजिन, प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई सेम मदर सेल और एंसेस्ट्रल सेल. टिश्यू रिप्रेजेंट्स ग्रुप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरली सिमिलर और डिसिमिलर सेल्स हैविंग कॉमन एंसेस्ट्रल ओरिजिन एंड आर कोऑर्डिनेटेड टू परफॉर्म कॉमन फंक्शन और सेट ऑफ डिफरेंट फंक्शंस. इन प्लांट टिश्यू सेल्स आर कोऑर्डिनेटेड बाई प्लाज्मोडेस्माटा. Types of tissue by Carl Nageli, based on ability to divide. First, meristematic tissue. Second, permanent tissue. Meristematic tissue made up of group of immature, undifferentiated cells. Cells have division capacity. Meristematic tissue is made up of group of dividing cells. Cells divide by mitosis to add new cells. Permanent tissue made up of group of non-dividing, mature, differentiated cells which lost division capacity temporarily or permanently. Cells are specialized or differentiated to perform specific functions like storage, mechanical support, conduction. Meristematic tissue made up of immature, undifferentiated group of dividing cells. Cells called meristematic cells. In Greek, meristos meaning divided or divisible. Meristem, specific location or area or region in plants where cell division occurs. For example, shoot tip, root tip. Term meristem given by scientist Nageli. Characteristic features of meristematic tissue. Number one, made up of small, homogeneous, thin-walled, compactly arranged, immature, undifferentiated cells. Number two, cells have only primary cell wall, that is cellulose and hemicellulose. Number three, cells are structurally similar, can be oval, spherical, polygonal, etc. Number four, cells are isodiametric, same size. Number five, intercellular spaces absent among cells. Number six, cells are in continuous stage of G1S, G2M. Number seven, vacuoles absent. If present, then small in size. Number eight, high metabolic rate. Storage of food absent. Characteristic features of meristematic tissue. Number nine, cells have high respiratory rate, produce large amount of energy, that is ATP. Number 10, cells have proplastids, mature plastid, that is chloroplast absent. Number 11, cells have high nucleocytoplasmic ratio, that is KI value. Number 12, cells have well-developed large conspicuous nucleus, dense cytoplasm, abundant ribosomes, active DNA and RNA. Number 13, meristematic tissue is pathogen free. Number 14, cells are rich in mitochondria. Number 15, cells do not have ergastic substances like crystals, resins, tannins, alkaloids, etc. Classification of meristematic tissue based on origin, three types: promeristem, primordial meristem, or meristem. Originated during seed germination, formation of seedling, present in hypocotyl radical and epicotyl plumule, also called embryonal meristem, as derived from embryo, represents short living meristem. Promeristem gives rise to primary meristem. Primary meristem originated during early stage of plant life, formed or derived by promeristem, helps in primary growth of plants, that is, increase in horizontal and vertical height or length, represented by root apical meristem, shoot apical meristem, intercalary meristem, and intrafascicular cambium. Primary meristem is long living, present throughout plant life. Primary meristem produces primary permanent tissues. Secondary meristem originated in later or late stage of plant life, originated from primary permanent tissue, especially from parenchyma, by dedifferentiation process, helps in increase in girth or width or circumference of basically dicot root and stem, which is called as secondary growth, represented by interfascicular cambium and cork cambium, that is phellogen. Secondary meristem produces secondary permanent tissues, absent in monocots. Meristematic tissue number 2, based on location or position. Three types: apical meristem, present at root apex or tip, and shoot apex or tip. At root apex, called root apical meristem, RAM, and at shoot apex, called shoot apical meristem, SAM. Intercalary meristem represents left behind cells of apical meristem, present between mature permanent cells, present at the base of nodes, for example mim, at the base of internodes, for example maize, bamboo, sugarcane, equisetum, a pteridophyte, and at the base of petiole of monocot leaves. Intercalary meristem is short living meristem, soon consumed in formation of permanent tissues. Apical meristem and intercalary meristem are primary meristem, help in primary growth, that is increase in length. Grazed parts of grasses regenerated due to activity of intercalary meristem present at the base of internodes. Lateral meristem found in old woody axis of dicot root and dicot stem, present at lateral sides of stem and root, absent in monocot root and stem, monocot and dicot leaf, flower and fruits. It is cylindrical in structure, represents secondary meristem, helps in increase in girth, that is secondary growth, represented by vascular cambium and cork cambium. Lateral meristem produces secondary permanent tissues. Lateral meristem, two types: vascular cambium, two components इंट्राफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम प्राइमरी ओरिजिन, इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम सेकेंडरी ओरिजिन। दस वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम इज पार्शली सेकेंडरी इन ओरिजिन और सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम। कॉर्क कैम्बियम ऑल्सो कॉल्ड फेलोजन कंप्लीट सेकेंडरी इन ओरिजिन। वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम प्रोड्यूसेस सेकेंडरी जाइलम, सेकेंडरी फ्लोएम एंड सेकेंडरी मेडुलरी रेज। कॉर्क कैम्बियम प्रोड्यूसेस कॉर्क दैट इज फेलम एंड सेकेंडरी कॉर्टेक्स दैट इज फेलोडम ड्यूरिंग सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ। अकॉर्डिंग टू हेबरलैंड एपिकल मेरिस्टेम बेस्ड ऑन फंक्शन डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री जोन्स और रीजन्स। प्रोटोडर्म फॉर्म्स एपिडर्मल टिश्यू सिस्टम दैट इज एपिडर्मिस, गार्ड सेल्स, हेयर्स, ट्राइकोम्स एक्सेट्रा। ग्राउंड मेरिस्टेम फॉर्म्स ग्राउंड टिश्यू सिस्टम दैट इज हाइपोडर्मिस, जनरल कॉर्टेक्स, एंडोडर्मिस, पेरिसाइकल, पिथ और मेडुला एंड पिथ रेज और मेडुलरी रेज। प्रोकैम्बियम फॉर्म्स वैस्कुलर टिश्यू सिस्टम दैट इज जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम। ऑल सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम आर लैटरल मेरिस्टेम बट ऑल लैटरल मेरिस्टेम आर नॉट सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इंट्राफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम एंड मार्जिनल मेरिस्टेम ऑफ लीफ आर प्राइमरी लैटरल मेरिस्टेम, बोथ आर प्राइमरी इन ओरिजिन। इंटरफेसिकुलर कैम्बियम ऑफ डाइकॉट स्टेम, वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम ऑफ डाइकॉट रूट, रूट एंड स्टेम ऑफ जिम्नोस्पर्म, कॉर्क कैम्बियम ऑफ डाइकॉट स्टेम, डाइकॉट रूट, रूट एंड स्टेम ऑफ जिम्नोस्पर्म आर सेकेंडरी लैटरल मेरिस्टेम, सेकेंडरी इन ओरिजिन। प्राइमरी मेरिस्टेम एपिकल मेरिस्टेम दैट इज रूट एपिकल मेरिस्टेम एंड शूट एपिकल मेरिस्टेम। इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टेम सेल डिवीजन, न्यू सेल्स लॉस्ट डिवीजन एबिलिटी, गेट स्ट्रक्चरली एंड फंक्शनली डिफरेंशिएटेड। प्रोसेस कॉल्ड डिफरेंशिएशन रिजल्ट्स इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्राइमरी परमानेंट टिश्यूज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल पैरेन्काइमा, पोलेन्काइमा, स्क्लेरेन्काइमा, जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम। जनरली पैरेन्काइमा सेल्स रीगेन डिवीजन एबिलिटी व्हेन नीडेड एंड एक्ट एज मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स। प्रोसेस कॉल्ड डिडिफरेंशिएशन रिजल्ट्स इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम, फॉर एग्जाम्पल वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम एंड कॉर्क कैम्बियम। सेल डिवीजन न्यू सेल्स लॉस्ट डिवीजन एबिलिटी एंड गेट डिफरेंशिएटेड। प्रोसेस कॉल्ड रीडिफरेंशिएशन रिजल्ट्स इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेकेंडरी परमानेंट टिश्यूज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल कॉर्क, सेकेंडरी कॉर्टेक्स, सेकेंडरी जाइलम, सेकेंडरी फ्लोएम, सेकेंडरी मेडुलरी रेज। कंपोजिशन और ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ एपिकल मेरिस्टेम। ऑल फंजाई एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द एल्गी हैव सिंपल बॉडी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। Here all cells divide to form the body, thus fungi and algae show diffused growth. In few advanced algae like Dictyota, Fucus, Sargassum, all bryophytes and few lower pteridophytes like Lycopodium, Selaginella have little advanced body organization. सिंगल सेल थियरी और एपिकल सेल थियरी गिवन बाय नागेली एंड हॉफमिस्टर अप्लीकेबल फॉर फ्यू एडवांस एल्गी, ऑल ब्रायोफाइट्स एंड फ्यू लोअर टेरिडोफाइट्स। हियर सिंगल पिरामिड शेप्ड मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल इन्वॉल्व्ड इन फॉर्मेशन ऑफ होल प्लांट बॉडी। हिस्टोजन थियरी गिवन बाय हैंस्टीन 1870 applicable for root apex organization. Root apex or root apical meristem divided into three zones or histogens. Dermatogen forms epiblema or epidermis of root. Periblem forms general cortex and endodermis. Plerome forms stele that is pericycle, xylem, phloem, pith. In dicot root, dermatogen forms both epiblema and root cap. In monocot root, dermatogen forms only epiblema, whereas calyptrogen forms root cap. Dicot root has three histogens, that is dermatogen, periblem and plerom, whereas monocot root has four histogens, that is dermatogen, calyptrogen derived from dermatogen, periblem and plerom. Histogen theory is not applicable for shoot apex organization. Quiescent center discovered by Klob in maize root. It represents inactive or least active part of root tip. It is inverted cup shaped or crescent shaped structure present between dermatogen and calyptrogen. Cytoplasm is less dense, DNA and RNA are less active, and ribosomes are less. It represents reserve meristem, works at the place of damaged root apical meristem. Quiescent center is surrounded by root apical meristem. Tunica corpus theory, given by scientist Smith 1924. It best describes shoot apex organization. Tunica is generally single layer dividing cells, also called mantle. Corpus is multi-layered large dividing cells, also called core. Tunica divides anticlinal manner and forms epidermis of shoot or stem. Corpus divide both anticlinal and periclinal manner and forms all other layers like hypodermis, general cortex, endodermis, pericycle, xylem, phloem, pith and pith ridge. Anticlinal division. It represents vertical cell division. Division occurs perpendicular to the axis. It results in formation of row of cells. Periclinal division. It represents horizontal cell division. Division occurs parallel to the axis. It results in formation of stack of cells. Cytohistological theory, given by Foster, divided shoot apex into two parts based on rate of division, that is mitosis. Vegetative shoot apex. Structurally, it is dome-shaped mostly or conical shaped. Tip or central part called summit having slow division rate. Lower lateral parts called flanks having fast division rate. Reproductive shoot apex, broad flat structure. Tip or central summit has fast division rate and lower lateral flanks have slow division rate. In vegetative shoot apex, summit helps in increase in length of stem and branches, whereas flanks help in formation of leaf primordia and bud, axillary bud. Axillary bud is condensed, compactly arranged apical meristem cells, which are left behind during growth of leaf primordia and shoot tip, present at the axil of leaf and stem or branches. Axillary bud either forms flower or branch. Plastochrone represents time period between formation of two successive leaf primordia. Permanent tissue, made up of group of non-dividing, mature, differentiated cells which are coordinated together to perform same function or set of functions and act as an unit. Produced by cell division in meristematic tissue. Cells produced by division in meristematic tissue get structurally and functionally differentiated and specialized to form permanent tissue. Permanent tissues either temporarily or permanently lost division ability and get involved in storage, mechanical support or conduction. Classification और टाइप्स ऑफ परमानेंट टिश्यूज। नंबर वन, बेस्ड ऑन ओरिजिन, प्राइमरी परमानेंट टिश्यू प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय प्राइमरी मेरिस्टेम, फॉर एग्जांपल पैरेन्काइमा, कोलेन्काइमा, स्क्लेरेन्काइमा, प्राइमरी जाइलम, प्राइमरी फ्लोएम, रिप्रेजेंट डिफरेंशिएटेड टिश्यूज। सेकेंडरी परमानेंट टिश्यूज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम, फॉर एग्जाम्पल कॉर्क दैट इज फिलम, सेकेंडरी कॉर्टेक्स दैट इज फेलोडर्म, सेकेंडरी जाइलम, सेकेंडरी फ्लोएम, सेकेंडरी मेडुलरी रिज, रिप्रेजेंट रीडिफरेंशिएटेड टिश्यूज। क्लासिफिकेशन और टाइप्स ऑफ परमानेंट टिश्यूज। नंबर टू, बेस्ड ऑन स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शंस, सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यूज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड होमोजेनस टिश्यूज मेड अप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरली सिमिलर सेल्स और वन टाइप ऑफ सेल्स। इट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री टाइप्स, पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू, कोलेन्काइमा टिश्यू, स्क्लेरेन्काइमा टिश्यू। कॉम्प्लेक्स परमानेंट टिश्यूज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड हेट्रोजेनस टिश्यूज मेड अप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरली डिसिमिलर सेल्स और मोर देन वन टाइप ऑफ सेल्स। इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, जाइलम, फ्लोएम। पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू रिप्रेजेंट्स मोस्ट प्रिमिटिव टिश्यू, इट इज फर्स्ट इवॉल्व्ड टिश्यू, इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय मैच्यूरेशन एंड डिफरेंशिएशन इन सेल्स एडेड बाय मेरिस्टमैटिक टिश्यू। इट इज मोस्ट अबंडेंट टिश्यू प्रेजेंट इन बल्क, दस रिप्रेजेंटिंग फंडामेंटल टिश्यू। पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू इज प्रीकर्सर ऑफ ऑल अदर टिश्यूज दैट इज कोलेन्काइमा, स्क्लेरेन्काइमा, सेल्स ऑफ जाइलम एंड सेल्स ऑफ फ्लोएम। पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू इज यूनिवर्सल टिश्यू फाउंड इन ऑल काइंड ऑफ प्लांट्स, द बॉडी ऑफ एडवांस मल्टी सेलुलर एल्गी एंड ऑल ब्रायोफाइट्स मेड अप ऑफ पैरेन्काइमा एंड पल्प ऑफ फ्रूट इज नथिंग बट पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू। स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू मेड अप ऑफ पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स, सेल्स कैन बी ओवल, स्फेरिकल, पॉलीगोनल, इलॉन्गेटेड एक्सेट्रा। सेल्स आर होमोजिनस एंड आइसोडायमेट्रिक दैट इज सिमिलर इन साइज और डायमीटर। सेल्स आर लिविंग हैविंग थिन प्राइमरी सेल वॉल मेड अप ऑफ मोर हेमी सेलुलोज, सेलुलोज एंड पेक्टिन। सेल्स हैव लिविंग प्रोटोप्लाज्म, लार्ज सेंट्रल वैक्यूल, पेरिफेरल साइटोप्लाज्म एंड न्यूक्लियस। सेल्स कैन बी कंपैक्टली अरेंज्ड विदाउट इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस और लूजली अरेंज्ड हैविंग इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस। सेल्स आर इलास्टिक, फ्लेक्सिबल, कैन ग्रो एंड एक्सपांड इन साइज। लोकेशंस ऑफ पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू फाउंड इन ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ प्लांट दैट इज रूट, स्टेम, लीव, फ्लावर, फ्रूट, सीड। फाउंड इन एपिडर्मिस, जर्नल कॉर्टेक्स, एंडोडर्मिस, पेरिसाइकल, जाइलम, फ्लोएम, पिथ एंड पिथुरेज। एब्सेंट इन हाइपोडर्मिस। मॉडिफिकेशंस ऑफ पैरेन्काइमा टिश्यू क्लोरेन्काइमा, क्लोरोप्लास्ट कंटेनिंग पैरेन्काइमा परफॉर्म्स फोटोसिंथेसिस। एरेन्काइमा, लार्ज एयर कैविटीज कंटेनिंग पैरेन्काइमा फॉर्म्ड ड्यू टू लाइसिस ऑफ सेल्स, एयर कैविटीज फिल्ड विथ गैसेस प्रोवाइड बायोंसी एंड हेल्प इन एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस ऑल्सो। फाउंड इन पार्ट्स ऑफ हाइड्रोफाइट्स। स्टिलेट पैरेन्काइमा, अ काइंड ऑफ स्टार शेप्ड एरेन्काइमा प्रेजेंट एट द बेस ऑफ लीव्स ऑफ बनाना एंड कैना। म्यूसिलेज पैरेन्काइमा, पैरेन्काइमा हैविंग स्टोर्ड वाटर एंड म्यूसिलेज। फाउंड इन जीरोफाइट्स दैट इज डेजर्ट प्लांट्स लाइक स्टेम एंड लीफ ऑफ एलोवेरा, कैक्टस, अपुंसिया एक्सेट्रा। Idioblast, special parenchyma involved in synthesis storage and secretion of waste materials like resins, gums, tannins, alkaloids, flavonoids, etc. Prosenchyma, thick cell walled spindle shaped parenchyma provides support, found in pericycle of root. Functions of parenchyma tissue: storage of materials in the vacuoles, perform photosynthesis, provide buoyancy, perform secretion of waste materials, provide support. Polenchyma tissue, made up of polenchymatous cells. Cells have primary cell wall only. Cells show uneven cell wall thickening, having deposition of pectin, mostly cellulose and hemicellulose, at corners. Cells are elastic, so great tensile or stretchable strength. Represents living mechanical tissue. Intercellular spaces absent. Protoplasm has small vacuoles. Cell wall is made up of pectocellulose, that is pectin plus cellulose. Location of polenchyma tissue: found below epidermis in young dicotystem or herbaceous dicotystem in the form of hypodermis layer. Absent in old dicotystem, monocotystem, dicot and monocot root. Also found in petiole of leaves, pedicel of flowers and margin of leaves. In sunflower, it is present in the form of homogeneous continuous layer, whereas in cucurbita, it is present in the form of discontinuous patches. Generally, polenchymatous cells are elongated, but may appear spherical, oval, angular, polygonal in shapes in transverse section. Function of polenchyma tissue: provides tensile strength to the plant organs, helps in bending against wind, prevents tearing and shearing of leaf margin. If contains chloroplast, can perform photosynthesis also. Sclerenchyma tissue, made up of sclerenchymatous cells. Cells are without protoplasm and dead on maturity. Cells have thick cell wall, secondary cell wall present, having deposition of lignin, cellulose, suberin, etc. Cells have lignocellulosic cell wall, that is lignin plus cellulose. Vacuoles and intercellular spaces are absent. Cells can be oval, hexagonal, elongated, spindle shaped, etc. It represents main mechanical tissue. Location of sclerenchyma tissue: found below epidermis in monocotystem in the form of hypodermis layer. Found in pericycle of dicotystem. Types of sclerenchyma tissue: two types. Number one, sclerites, represents oval, spherical or polygonal cells. Cells are highly thick walled with obliterated lumen, very narrow lumen. Cells have branched or unbranched pits. Sclerites provide grittiness, hardness and stiffness to plant parts or organs. Location of sclerites: found in fruit wall of nuts, pulp of guava, pea, sapota, etc., called brachysclerite or stone cells. Found in seed coat of legumes, that is pea and beans, called macrosclerites. Found in tea, that is thia plant leaves, called asterosclerites. Sclerenchyma fiber: elongated, spindle shaped, having pointed or tapering ends, having narrow lumen, that is cell cavity. Found in bunch and have unbranched pits, types of sclerenchyma fiber, three types. Number one, surface fiber found at the surface of seeds and fruits. For example, coconut, that is gossypium fiber, represents outgrowth of testa, outer covering of cotton seed. Cotton fiber is false fiber made up of cellulose. Coconut fiber, coir of coconut, represents fibrous mesocarp of the fruit. Surface fibers, also called filling fibers, used in filling of furnitures, board, and also used in making rope. Number two, xylem fiber, that is intraxillary fiber, that is wood fiber. Non-commercial fiber found in secondary xylem cannot be knitted or weaved. For example, munj fiber, that is Saccharum munja. Number three, phloem fiber, also called extra xylary fiber, also called bast fiber. Most useful commercial fiber can be knitted or weaved. For example, Corcorus capsularis, jute fiber, Crotalaria gentia, sun hemp fiber, Cannabinis sativa, hemp fiber, Linum usitatissimum, flax fiber. Longest fiber present in rami plant, that is 55 cm. Longest commercial fiber is jute fiber. Functions of sclerenchyma tissue: help in tolerating compression, stretching, shearing, breaking, etc. It prevents bending of plant parts, provides mechanical support, dead mechanical tissue against environmental stimuli, lumen. It represents cavity of cell or inner space of cell. Parenchyma has more lumen, followed by collenchyma, least lumen present in sclerenchyma tissue. Complex permanent tissue made up of more than one type of cells acting as an unit, involved in transportation or translocation of materials, hence also called conducting tissue or vascular tissue, made up of structurally dissimilar cells, hence represent heterogeneous tissue. Types of complex permanent tissue: two types. Number one, xylem, also called hydrome or wood. Number two, phloem, also called leptome or bast. Xylem is water and mineral conducting vascular tissue. Phloem is food, that is organic compounds conducting vascular tissue. Complex permanent tissues, that is xylem and phloem, formed during vascularization process due to differentiation of procambium cells into primary xylem and primary phloem simultaneously. Xylem, term xylem given by Nageli, also called hydrome by Haverland, also called wood, that is secondary xylem, represents water, mineral, and inorganic substances conducting tissue, transport materials unidirectional, that is from bottom, root, to top or upper parts, that is stem, branches, leaves, etc. Cells of xylem are dead without protoplasm for efficient conduction. Xerophytes have well-developed xylem, whereas hydrophytes have poorly developed xylem. Structure of xylem. Xylem structurally made up of four different cells: tracheid, vessels, xylem fiber, xylem parenchyma. Tracheid, vessel, xylem fiber, these free cells are dead. Xylem parenchyma is living cell. Tracheid and vessel together called tracheoid elements. Tracheid represents most primitive conducting unit of xylem found in all vascular plants. Structurally, it is spindle shaped or elongated tube like, having tapering ends or chisel like ends. On maturity, becomes dead without protoplasm, having highly thick lignified cell wall with very narrow inner cavity or lumen. Tracheid represents single cell structure, present one above other, connected through bordered pits, forming a channel. Tracheid shows different types or pattern of lignin deposition like annular, spiral, scalariform, reticulate, pitted, etc. Tracheids of gymnosperm have presence of tertiary cell wall also. Annular type tracheid is most primitive. Annular and spiral type tracheids found in protoxylem, whereas reticulate and pitted type tracheids found in metaxylem. Tracheids are found in all types of vascular plants, that is aerophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms. Functions of tracheid. Tracheids are main water conducting units or cells in pteridophyte and gymnosperms, as vessels are absent here. Tracheids help in water conduction in association with vessels in angiosperms. Vessel, also called trachea, represents advanced type of water conducting unit or cell of xylem. Vessel is thick walled, dead cell without protoplasm, cylindrical or tube like structure with broad ends. Vessel exists in the form of vessel column, representing interconnected multi-celled structure, present one above other and have dissolved end walls or cross walls on maturity. Individual cell of vessel column called vessel member or vessel element. During young condition, the cross walls or end walls of vessel members in vessel column are perforated, that is having presence of many pores. Perforations at end walls of tracheids are absent. On maturity, obliquely perforated cross walls in vessel column get dissolved, resulting in formation of dead syncytic structure or cell that is formed due to fusion of cells. Vessels also have all different types of lignin deposition as found in tracheids. Location of vessel. Vessel is characteristic feature of angiosperms, generally absent in pteridophytes and gymnosperms. Exception: Selaginella, Dryopteris, Marsilia, Pteris are advanced pteridophytes having vessels. Ephedra, Netum, Wilbesia of order Nitales of gymnosperms also have vessels. Primitive families of angiosperm like Vinturaceae, Trochodendraceae, Tetracenturaceae lack vessels. Few angiospermic plants like Brymis, Dracaena, Yucca also lack vessels. Function of vessel. Vessels are main water conducting structure in angiosperms. Vessels also provide mechanical support to the plant organs. Xylem fiber represents spindle shaped, thick walled, dead sclerenchyma fiber. Found in secondary xylem, absent in primary xylem. Can be septate or aseptate. Xylem fiber present in secondary xylem, that is wood of angiosperm, and absent in secondary xylem, that is wood of gymnosperm. Thus gymnosperm wood is called softwood. Xylem fiber has highly obliterated lumen. Xylem fiber provides mechanical support. Xylem parenchyma represents elongated with thin cellulogic cell wall. Living cell stores food materials like starch, fat, and other compounds like tannin, resin, alkaloid, etc. Xylem parenchyma in the form of ray parenchyma helps in lateral conduction or radial conduction of water. Complex permanent tissues, that is xylem and phloem, absent in gametophytes, for example algae and bryophyta, and present in sporophytes, for example pteridophyta, gymnosperm and angiosperm. Types of xylem based on origin. Primary xylem, produced by primary meristem, that is procambium, during primary growth, during vascularization, found in all kinds of vascular plants. Secondary xylem, produced by secondary meristem, that is vascular cambium, during secondary growth, found only in root and stem of gymnosperm and dicot root and dicot stem of angiosperm. Types of primary xylem based on development. Protoxylem, first formed primary xylem having small underdeveloped less advanced cells. Protoxylem has vessels with narrow lumen. Metaxylem, laterally formed or developed primary xylem. Cells are large, well developed, advanced. Metaxylem has vessels with broad lumen. Types of primary xylem based on arrangement of protoxylem and metaxylem. Exarch xylem, protoxylem present towards outer side or periphery or pericycle or epidermis. Metaxylem present towards inner side or center or pith, that is medulla, found in root. Endarch xylem, protoxylem present towards inner side or center or pith, that is medulla. Metaxylem present towards outer side or periphery or pericycle or epidermis, found in stem. Mesarch xylem, protoxylem present in the center, whereas metaxylem present around protoxylem. Metaxylem surround the protoxylem, found in rhizome of Dryopteris, that is pteridophyta. Primary xylem show two types of development pattern. Centripetal development. Development of primary xylem occurs from periphery towards center. Less developed immature protoxylem present towards periphery and mature developed metaxylem present towards center, found in endarch type xylem, that is in root. Centrifugal development. Development of primary xylem occurs from center towards periphery. Less developed immature protoxylem present towards center and developed mature metaxylem present towards periphery, found in endarch type of xylem, that is in stem and leaf. Phloem. Term phloem given by Nageli, also called leptome by Haverland and Bast. Phloem is food conducting vascular tissue, transport food or organic substances from area of synthesis, that is source, leaves, to area of utilization or storage, that is sink, stem, branches, bud, fruit, root, etc. Phloem generally performs bidirectional transportation that is upward as well as downward. In adverse condition, food can be transported from area of storage, that is sink, to other parts through phloem. Phloem performs active transport, that is ATP dependent transport of food, in the form of dissolved sucrose, that is disaccharide. Thus, conducting units of phloem, that is sieve tube and companion cell, are living components or cells of phloem. Sieve tube, companion cell, phloem parenchyma, phloem fiber, with reference to phloem of angiosperm. Sieve cell, albuminous cell, phloem parenchyma, phloem fiber, with reference to phloem of pteridophyta and gymnosperm. In phloem, three cells are living, that is sieve tube, companion cell and phloem parenchyma, and one cell is dead, that is phloem fiber. Sieve tube, long tube like interconnected structure made up of many sieve members or sieve elements present one above other. Sieve tube represents living syncytic cell made up of many fused sieve elements. Nucleus is absent. Sieve element has swollen or bulged cross wall, that is end wall. At end wall, there is presence of perforated sieve plate having many pores called sieve pores. Internally, sieve element has large central vacuole and peripheral cytoplasm. In mature sieve tube or sieve element, nucleus is absent, enucleated. Function of active transportation of sucrose via sieve tube is controlled by nucleus of companion cells. Sieve tube absent in pteridophytes and gymnosperms. Instead, sieve cell is present. Sieve cell is spindle-shaped structure having tapering ends and perforated sieve area at lateral side or lateral wall. Sieve tube represents main food conducting cell or unit in phloem of angiosperms. Companion cell represents thin-walled, elongated, specialized parenchyma cell present on lateral side of sieve tube. Each sieve member has association of companion cell. Companion cell has large elongated nucleus which controls transportation of food through sieve tube. There is presence of pit field at longitudinal common wall of sieve tube and companion cell. Pit field has plasmodesmata. Sieve tube and companion cell are connected or communicated via pit field. Both sieve tube and companion cell arise from same mother cell, thus called sister cells. Sieve tube and companion cell are ontogenetically similar, that is having same life history and development process. Companion cell, also called helper cell, as it is helping sieve tube in transportation. Companion cells control transport of food across sieve tube and also tolerate wall pressure gradient. Phloem parenchyma have thin cellulogic cell wall involved in storage of food and other compounds. Ray parenchyma, that is phloem rays, involved in radial conduction of food. Phloem parenchyma is absent in monocots and also not found in herbaceous dicots. Phloem fiber, also called bast fiber. Spindle-shaped, thick-walled dead cells. In primary phloem, phloem fiber is absent in protophloem and present in metaphloem. Phloem fiber generally absent in primary phloem but present in secondary phloem. Phloem fiber has commercial importance and also provides mechanical support. Types of phloem based on origin. Primary phloem produced from primary meristem, that is procambium, during primary growth, that is vascularization process. Secondary phloem produced by secondary meristem, that is vascular cambium, during secondary growth. Types of primary phloem. Protophloem, phloem having immature, underdeveloped, less advanced small cells. Protophloem has sieve tube with narrow lumen. Protophloem produced earlier. Metaphloem, phloem having mature, developed, advanced large cells. Metaphloem has sieve tube with broad lumen. Metaphloem produced later. Callous plug or callous pad. On arrival of unfavorable condition or dropping condition or leaf falling condition or autumn condition, there is deposition of callous beta 1,3 glucan around sieve pores of sieve tube, known as callous plug or callous pad. Formation of callous plug reduces pore size or radius or diameter of sieve pores. Callous plug formation slow down phloem transport in autumn season, which also results in slow growth of plant. On returning of favorable condition, callous plug is dissolved by callase enzyme, thus pore size become normal. P protein or phloem protein. Sieve tube synthesize a compound called P protein. P protein acts as sealing material or sealing mechanism for wounding or breaking of phloem parts along with callose. P protein also help in active transport, that is ATP depend, of food. Tissue system. Group of several tissues having common origin, working as an unit, performing similar function or set of different functions called tissue system. Based on structure, that is morphology, and position, that is location, von Sesse gave three types of tissue system in plants. Epidermal tissue system, ground tissue system, vascular tissue system. Each tissue system has particular set of tissues which are associated together to perform specific function. Epidermal tissue system arises from protoderm or dermatogen, made up of epidermis and associated structures like stomata, hairs and trichome. Hair and trichome also called epidermal appendages. Ground tissue system arise from ground meristem or periblem, divided into three zones or three regions. Number one, cortex consists of hypodermis, general cortex and endodermis. Number two, pericycle. Number three, pit or medulla. Vascular tissue system arise from procambium or pleurum, made up of xylem, phloem and cambium. Epidermal tissue system, ETS, found on outermost part of plant organs, root, stem and leaf. ETS includes three different components. Number one, epidermis. Number two, stomata, that is epidermal associated structure. Number three, epidermal appendages, root hair and shoot hair, also called trichome. Epidermis, it forms outer covering of root, stem and leaf. मेड अप ऑफ थिन वॉल्ड कंपैक्टली अरेंज्ड पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स विदाउट इंटरसेलुलर स्पेस क्लोरोप्लास्ट एब्सेंट हैव लार्ज वैक्यूल एंड पेरिफेरल साइटोप्लाज्म मोस्टली एग्जिस्ट इन सिंगल लेयर एंड हैज डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट विथ एनवायरमेंट इन नेरियम बनियन दैट इज फाइकस पेप्रोमिया एंड बेगोनिया एपिडर्मिस इज मल्टीलेयर द एपिडर्मिस ऑफ रूट इज कॉल्ड राइजोडर्मिस और एपिब्लेमा और पिलीफेरस लेयर एपिडर्मिस जनरली फाउंड इन प्राइमरी स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्लांट पार्ट्स इन द एपिडर्मिस ऑफ यंग स्टेम एंड लीफ देयर इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ थिक और थिन वाटर इम्परमिएबल वैक्सी लेयर कॉल्ड क्यूटिकल मेड अप ऑफ क्यूटिन अ टाइप ऑफ लिपिड क्यूटिकल इज एब्सेंट इन रूट एपिडर्मिस फंक्शंस ऑफ एपिडर्मिस provide protection to inner structures or tissues, prevent loss of water due to transpiration, involved in absorption of water with reference to root epidermis, resist invasion of pathogens, stomata, singular stoma. Stoma is a pore or an aperture which is surrounded by two guard cells. Guard cells are joined at endings or tips and are free in the center that results in pore formation. Pore together with guard cells called stoma or stomata. Guard cells are special modified epidermal cells which are kidney or bean shaped in dicot stomata and are dumbbell shaped in monocot stomata. In stomata, there are two guard cells generally. Guard cells have nucleus and presence of chloroplast. Guard cells have radially arranged cellulose microfibrils. Inner wall of guard cell is thick and outer wall of guard cell is thin. Guard cells are surrounded by special epidermal cell without chloroplast called subsidiary cells or helper cells. Guard cells control opening and closing of stomata. Functions of stomata. Stomata performs process of transpiration, that is loss of water in the form of water vapor. Stomata is also involved in exchange of gases, that is O2 and CO2. When guard cells are turgid due to endoosmosis of water, stomata opened. When guard cells are flaccid due to exosmosis of water, stomata closed. In radial arrangement of cellulose microfibrils inside guard cells, one end of microfibrils attached with outer wall and other end is attached with inner wall. Microfibrils help in turgid and flaccid condition of guard cells. Epidermal appendages. Number one, trichome represents extra cells associated with stem epidermis. It can be branched or unbranched, can be stiff or soft. Cuticle layer is present. It is long living structure. Trichome prevents loss of water. Trichome is secretory or glandular structure, secretes sticky materials for capturing, killing and obtaining nutrients from insects, etc. Number two, root hair represents outgrowth or outfold of epiblema cells of root. It is single cell tubular outgrowth of epiblema cells having vacuole and peripheral cytoplasm. root hair is soft and unbranched. Root hair is short living. Cuticle layer is absent. Cells of epiblema that form root hair called trichoblast. Root hair involved in absorption of water and increase water absorption surface area of root. Trichome is multicellular structure. Types of stomata. Epistomatic stomata. Stomata present on upper surface of leaves. For example, floating leaves of lotus, Victoria nymphaea. Hypostomatic stomata. Stomata present on lower surface of leaves. For example, dicot leaves. Amphistomatic stomata. Stomata present on both upper and lower surface of leaves. For example, monocot leaves. Astomatic stomata. Stomata absent on leaves. For example, Vallisneria hydrilla. Photoactive stomata. Stomata opened during day and closed during night. Scotoactive stomata. Stomata closed during day and opened during night. For example, desert plants. Ground tissue system, that is GTS, forms bulk of plant body, contains or made up of all kinds of simple permanent tissues, represent tissue system except epidermal and vascular tissue system, also called fundamental tissue system. Zones or regions of ground tissue system. Ground tissue system divided into three zones. Number one, cortex, found below epidermis and above pericycle, divided into three different layers. Small a, hypodermis, present below epidermis and above general cortex, found in dicot and monocot stem, absent in dicot and monocot root. Hypodermis is few layered, that is 3 to 4, or multilayered. In dicot stem, made up of collenchyma tissue, and in monocot stem, made up of sclerenchyma tissue. Hypodermis provides mechanical support. In young dicot stem, collenchymatous hypodermis also performs photosynthesis. Small b, general cortex, found below hypodermis and above endodermis in stem, and below epiblema and above endodermis in root, made up of multilayered, loosely arranged parenchyma tissue or cells, also contains oil ducts and resin ducts, involved in storage of food and other substances. Small c, endodermis, last layer of cortex zone, present below general cortex and above pericycle. Endodermis is absent in monocot stem, found in dicot stem and monocot and dicot root. In dicot stem, endodermis is single layered, made up of compactly arranged without intercellular spaces, barrel shaped cells, contain starch grain. So endodermis, also called starch sheath, gives blue color with iodine. Endodermis, related to dicot and monocot root, endodermis shows presence of Casparian strip, which is a band-like deposition of suberin, water impermeable waxy material, on radial and tangential walls of endodermal cells. Casparian strip discovered by scientist Casperi. Due to presence of Casparian strip, endodermis acts as watertight dam, prevents leakage of water from inner layers. Casparian strip is absent in those endodermal cells which are present in front of protoxylem. These cells are called passage cells or transfusion cells. Presence of Casparian strip helps in unidirectional entry of water towards xylem through passage cells. Pericycle. It is second zone of ground tissue system. Present in dicot stem and dicot and monocot root. Absent in monocot stem. Pericycle is present below endodermis. In dicot stem, pericycle is multicellular, homogeneous or heterogeneous layer made up of parenchyma cells or patches of alternating parenchyma and sclerenchyma cells. Part of pericycle present above the phloem represent semilunar patch of sclerenchyma cells. In dicot stem, pericycle provides mechanical support and also involved in storage. In root, pericycle is one to few layered made up of thick-walled parenchymatous cells. In dicot root, pericycle performs formation of lateral roots and also formation of strips of vascular cambium and complete cork cambium, whereas in monocot root, pericycle form only lateral roots. Root hairs and branches of stem are exogenous in origin. Lateral roots and adventitious roots are endogenous in origin, develop from pericycle, endodermis or phloem. Lateral roots develop from pericycle cells present in front of xylem, pith also called medulla. Third zone of ground tissue system made up of loosely arranged parenchymatous cells having intercellular spaces present in the central part of dicot stem, dicot and monocot root. Absent in monocot stem. In dicot stem and monocot root, pith is well developed and conspicuous, whereas in dicot root, pith is less developed, inconspicuous or even absent. Pith rays, also called medullary rays, generally found in dicot stem. It represents cells of outer part of pith which get extended passing through the vascular bundle, help in radial conduction of materials. Pith is involved in storage of food and other compounds like tannin, alkaloid, flavonoid, etc. with reference to leaf. Ground tissue system is undifferentiated, not divided into its different zones. Hypodermis, general cortex, endodermis, pericycle, pith and pith rays are absent in leaf. In leaf, ground tissue system is represented by or called mesophyll, can be differentiated into palisade tissue and spongy tissue. Vascular tissue system, also called fascicular tissue system, conducting tissue system or specific tissue system. Vascular tissue system made up of complex permanent tissues, that is xylem and phloem, involved in conduction or transportation. Vascular tissue system arise from procambium. Xylem represents water conducting vascular tissue and phloem represents food conducting vascular tissue. Xylem and phloem together called as or form vascular bundle. Types of vascular bundle based on relative position of xylem and phloem. First, radial vascular bundle. Xylem and phloem are present at different axes or radii. Xylem and phloem alternate with each other. Here, xylem is exarch. Between xylem and phloem, cambium, that is intrafascicular cambium, is absent. For example, dicot and monocot root. Conjoint vascular bundle. Xylem and phloem are present at same axis. Types. First, collateral type. Phloem present outer side and xylem present inner side. Further divided into two types. Small a, open type. Between phloem and xylem, strip of cambium, that is intrafascicular cambium, is present. For example, dicot stem. Small b, closed type. Between xylem and phloem, strip of cambium is absent. For example, monocot stem. Second, bicollateral type. Phloem is present on both outer side and inner side the xylem. It is always open type. For example, solanaceae, myrtaceae, cucurbitaceae. Concentric vascular bundle. One vascular tissue surrounds other vascular tissue. Types. First, hydrocentric or amphicribal type. Phloem surrounds the xylem. Xylem present in the center surrounded by phloem. For example, prunus, dicot, fern. Second, leptocentric, amphivessel type. Xylem surrounds the phloem. Phloem present in the center surrounded by xylem. For example, yucca, dracaena, stele. All the tissues or layers present inside endodermis called stele. Stele includes pericycle, xylem, phloem, pith and pithrage. Stele represents central mass of vascular tissues with or without pith covered by pericycle. Stele originated in division pteridophyta. Tissues present inside the stele called intrastellar tissue and tissues present outside the stele called extrastellar tissues. Tears of dicot root. Small a, epidermis or epiblema. Outermost layer of root, usually single layered. Outer wall of many cells protrude outward forming tubular structures called root hair. Epiblema also called piliferous layer. Small b, cortex or general cortex. Present below epiblema up to endodermis. Several layers of parenchymatous cells, thin-walled and loosely packed, offers no resistance to water movement. Small c, endodermis. Present below general cortex, acts as border between cortex and pericycle. Comprises a single layer of barrel-shaped cells having special thickening of suberin in their radial and tangential walls called Casparian strip. Casparian strip prevent diffusion of water. Tears of dicot root. Endodermis functions as biological checkpost. Small d, pericycle, present next to endodermis, made up of thick-walled parenchymatous cells, may be single layered to several layered, has important role during secondary growth in dicot root, give rise to part of vascular cambium and lateral roots. Small e, vascular bundles. Radial vascular bundle is present with exarch xylem, can be diarch to hexarch, that is 2 to 6 xylems alternate with 2 to 6 phloems. Between xylem and phloem, patches of parenchymatous cells present called conjunctive tissue. Small f, pith, found in center, it is small and inconspicuous, can be absent also. Tears of monocot root. Small a, epidermis, also called epiblema. Outermost layer having large number of unicellular root hairs. Cuticle and stomata are absent. Small b, general cortex, made up of loosely arranged parenchymatous cells. Small c, endodermis, very distinct, मेड अप ऑफ बैरल शेप्ड सेल्स हैविंग कैस्पेरियन स्ट्रिप्स, स्मॉल डी पेरिसाइकल ऑल्सो वेरी डिस्टिंक्ट गिव्स राइज टू लैटरल रूट्स ओनली, पीएस ऑफ मोनोकॉट रूट, स्मॉल ई वैस्कुलर बंडल्स, रेडियल टाइप अरेंज्ड अलोंग डिफरेंट रेडियाई, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर क्लोज्ड टाइप, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर पॉलीआर्क दैट इज प्रेजेंस ऑफ मोर देन सिक्स जाइलम्स एंड फ्लोएम्स, एक्सार्क जाइलम, फ्लोएम पैरेन्काइमा इज एब्सेंट इन फ्लोएम, स्मॉल एफ कंजंक्टिव टिश्यू, पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स प्रेजेंट इन बिटवीन पैचेज ऑफ जाइलम एंड फ्लोएम, स्मॉल जी पिथ लार्ज एंड वेल डेवलप्ड, पीएस ऑफ डाइकॉट स्टेम, इपिडर्मिस आउटर मोस्ट प्रोटेक्टिव लेयर मेड अप ऑफ सिंगल लेयर ऑफ सेल्स एंड इज क्यूटिकुलराइज्ड, मे बेयर ट्राइकोम्स एंड फ्यू स्टोमाटा इन यंग स्टेम, हाइपोडर्मिस आउटर एरिया ऑफ कॉर्टेक्स जोन प्रेजेंट बिलो इपिडर्मिस कंसिस्ट ऑफ 3 to 5 लेयर्स ऑफ पोलेनकाइमेटस सेल्स, सेल्स आर मच थिकेंड एट कॉर्नर्स ड्यू टू सेलुलोज हेमीसेलुलोज एंड पेक्टिन, इंटर सेलुलर स्पेसेस एब्सेंट, प्रोवाइड्स मैकेनिकल सपोर्ट टू यंग स्टेम, जनरल कॉर्टेक्स बिलो हाइपोडर्मिस एंड अबव एंडोडर्मिस मेड अप ऑफ पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स, सेल्स आर थिन वॉल्ड राउंड शेप्ड इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस प्रेजेंट, पीएस ऑफ डाइकॉटिक स्टेम, एंडोडर्मिस इनर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ कॉर्टेक्स जोन, सेल्स स्टोर स्टार्च ग्रेन्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड स्टार्च सीथ गिव्स ब्लू कलर विथ आयोडीन, पेरिसाइकल प्रेजेंट बिलो एंडोडर्मिस एंड अबव फ्लोएम प्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सेमीलुनार पैचेस ऑफ स्क्लेरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स ऑल्सो कंसिस्ट ऑफ पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स मेड अप ऑफ जाइलम फ्लोएम एंड कैम्बियम बिटवीन द टू, जाइलम इज एंडार्क सिचुएटेड टूवर्ड्स द इनर साइड, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर कॉन्जॉइंट कोलैटरल ओपन टाइप, रिंग लाइक अरेंजमेंट ऑफ वैस्कुलर बंडल्स अराउंड द सेंट्रल पिथ फाउंड इन डाइकॉट स्टेम, पीएस ऑफ डाइकॉट स्टेम, पिथ और मेडुला सेंट्रल पोर्शन ऑफ स्टेम मेड अप ऑफ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ राउंडेड शेप पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स हैविंग लार्ज इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस, मेडुलरी रेज और पिथ रेज, सेल्स ऑफ पिथ प्रेजेंट बिटवीन वैस्कुलर बंडल्स कंस्टिट्यूट द पिथ रेज, दीज आर पैरेन्काइमेटस एक्सटेंशन ऑफ पिथ सेल्स प्रेजेंट रेडियली बिटवीन द वैस्कुलर बंडल्स गिविंग द अपीयरेंस ऑफ रेज, हेल्प इन रेडियल कंडक्शन ऑफ मटेरियल्स, पीएस ऑफ मोनोकॉट स्टेम, इपिडर्मिस आउटर मोस्ट लेयर मेड अप ऑफ सिंगल लेयर ऑफ सेल्स कवर्ड विथ क्यूटिकल स्टोमाटा मे बी प्रेजेंट, हाइपोडर्मिस लाइज बिलो इपिडर्मिस कंस्टिट्यूट्स स्क्लेरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स प्रोवाइड्स मैकेनिकल सपोर्ट टू द स्टेम्स, ग्राउंड टिश्यू मेन एरिया ऑफ मोनोकॉट स्टेम ऑक्युपाइड बाई ग्राउंड टिश्यू, इट इज नॉट वेल डिफरेंशिएटेड इनटू जनरल कॉर्टेक्स एंडोडर्मिस पेरिसाइकल पिथ एंड पिथ रेज, ऑल द पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स प्रेजेंट बिलो हाइपोडर्मिस कंस्टिट्यूट ग्राउंड टिश्यू, पीएस ऑफ मोनोकॉट स्टेम, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स लार्ज नंबर ऑफ वैस्कुलर बंडल्स प्रेजेंट, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर फाउंड स्कैटर्ड इन द होल ग्राउंड टिश्यू, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर स्मॉलर इन साइज एंड डेंसली अरेंज्ड टूवर्ड्स पेरिफेरी, बट लार्जर वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर लूजली अरेंज्ड टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ स्टेम, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर ओवल इन आउटलाइन, कैम्बियम इज एब्सेंट सराउंडेड बाई स्क्लेरेन्काइमेटस सीथ कॉल्ड बंडल सीथ। वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर कॉन्जॉइंट क्लोज्ड टाइप, जाइलम इज एंडार्क एंड वाटर कंटेनिंग साइजोलाइसिजिनस कैविटीज आर प्रेजेंट. लीफ, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एनाटॉमी लीव्स आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स. नंबर वन डॉर्सीवेंट्रल और बाइफेसियल लीफ फाउंड इन डाइकॉट प्लांट्स जेनरली रिमेन हॉरिजॉन्टल और परपेंडिकुलर दैट इज 90 degrees टू स्टेम और ब्रांचेस एंड सनलाइट फॉल्स ऑन अपर सरफेस. अपर सरफेस ऑफ लीफ इज कॉल्ड वेंट्रल सरफेस और डार्सियल सरफेस एंड लोअर सरफेस ऑफ लीफ इज कॉल्ड डॉर्सल सरफेस और बाक्सियल सरफेस. डॉर्सल एंड वेंट्रल सरफेसेस ऑफ लीफ डिफर इन कलर एंड एनाटॉमिकल फीचर. अपर सरफेस हैज मोर क्यूटिकल, डार्क ग्रीन इन कलर एंड विदाउट स्टोमाटा, वेयर एज लोअर सरफेस हैज लेस क्यूटिकल, लाइट ग्रीन विथ मोर स्टोमाटा. नंबर टू आइसोबाइलेट्रल और इक्विफेसियल लीफ फाउंड इन मोनोकॉट प्लांट्स लीव्स जनरली अटैच्ड वर्टिकल, बोथ अपर एंड लोअर सरफेसेस आर इक्वल ग्रीन, हैविंग इक्वल डिपोजिशन ऑफ क्यूटिकल, स्टोमाटा प्रेजेंट ऑन बोथ सरफेसेस एंड आर सिमिलर टू वन अनदर. डॉर्सीवेंट्रल लीफ हैज हाइपोस्टोमैटिक स्टोमाटा एंड आइसोबाइलेट्रल लीफ हैज एम्फीस्टोमैटिक स्टोमाटा. टीएस ऑफ डाइकॉट लीफ और डॉर्सीवेंट्रल लीफ. एपिडर्मिस कवर्स बोथ अपर एंड लोअर सरफेसेस ऑफ लीफ. एपिडर्मिस कवरिंग द अपर सरफेस कॉल्ड डार्सियल और अपर एपिडर्मिस, व्हाइल एपिडर्मिस कवरिंग द लोअर सरफेस कॉल्ड अबाक्सियल और लोअर एपिडर्मिस. अडाक्सियल एपिडर्मिस इज आउटर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ लीफ मेड अप ऑफ सिंगल लेयर ऑफ पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स. आउटर वॉल्स आर क्यूटिकुलराइज्ड एंड सेल्स हैव नो क्लोरोप्लास्ट इन देम. स्टोमाटा आर जनरली लेस इन नंबर और एब्सेंट. अबाक्सियल एपिडर्मिस इज सिमिलर टू अडाक्सियल एपिडर्मिस बट इट बेयर्स मोर स्टोमाटा एंड लेस क्यूटिकल. सब स्टोमाटल कैविटी प्रेजेंट बिलो स्टोमाटा. टीएस ऑफ डाइकॉट लीफ और डॉर्सीवेंट्रल लीफ. क्लोरोप्लास्ट आर एब्सेंट इन एपिडर्मल सेल्स ऑफ लीफ बट आर प्रेजेंट इन गार्ड सेल्स ऑफ स्टोमाटा. स्मॉल बी मेसोफिल represents tissue present in between upper and lower epidermis. It is ground tissue of leaf made up of thin walled chloroplast containing parenchymatous cells. Mesophyll is photosynthetic tissue of leaf divided into two regions. TS of dicot leaf or dorsiventral leaf. Number one, palisade parenchyma lies below the upper epidermis, hence adaxially placed. Palisade parenchyma extends up to one or two layers made up of elongated cells arranged vertically forming 90-degree angle with upper epidermis. Cells lies parallel to each other. Cells have numerous chloroplasts and take active part in photosynthesis. Cells are closely packed without intercellular spaces. TS of dicot leaf or dorsiventral leaf. Number two, spongy parenchyma lies below the palisade parenchyma and extends up to lower epidermis. Hence, abaxially placed, made up of oval or rounded cells without any particular arrangement. Cells have large intercellular spaces. Due to presence of large intercellular spaces and air cavities, this tissue is called spongy parenchyma. Cells also have chloroplast and participate in photosynthesis. TS of dicot leaf और डॉर्सी वेंट्रल लीफ, स्मॉल सी वैस्कुलर बंडल्स। वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर स्कैटर्ड इन द स्पॉन्जी पैरेन्काइमा, कैन बी सीन इन द मिडरिब एंड वेन्स ऑफ द लीफ। वेन्स वेरी इन द थिकनेस ड्यू टू रेटिकुलेट वेनेशन इन लीफ। साइज ऑफ वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर डिपेंड ऑन साइज ऑफ द वेन्स। वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर लार्जर इन थिकर वेन्स एंड स्मॉलर इन थिनर वेन्स एंड वेनलेट्स। वैस्कुलर बंडल इज कॉन्जॉइंट क्लोज्ड। थिक वॉल्ड बंडल सीथ सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट अराउंड वैस्कुलर बंडल्स। जाइलम प्रेजेंट टूवर्ड्स अपर साइड। टीयर्स ऑफ मोनोकॉट लीफ और आइसोबाइलेट्रल लीफ। Epidermis. There is an upper or adaxial and lower or abaxial epidermis. Both are made up of single layer of cells and possess stomata. Stomata are near equal in number on both epidermis. Both surfaces are equally cuticularized. In grasses, some adaxial epidermal cells along the veins modify themselves in large empty colorless cells called bulliform cells, help in rolling and unrolling, that is curling and uncurling of leaf during high temperature, drought and lack of water, help in minimizing loss of water. Tears of monocot leaf or isobilateral leaf. Sub stomatal cavity is present below the stoma of abaxial epidermis. Mesophyll lies between upper and lower epidermis, not differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. Cells are spherical in shape and are irregularly arranged. Cells contain chloroplast and carry out photosynthesis. Mesophyll is heterogeneous, that is differentiated in dicot leaf, and homogeneous, that is undifferentiated in monocot leaf. Tears of monocot leaf or isobilateral leaf. Vascular bundles. There are a number of large and small vascular bundles surrounded by thin-walled bundle sheath cells. Vascular bundles are conjoint closed. Xylem lies towards the upper epidermis and phloem lies towards the lower epidermis. In monocot leaf, near similar sizes of vascular bundles are present due to parallel venation. Dicot root, monocot root. Pericycle gives rise to secondary or lateral roots, vascular cambium and cork cambium. Pericycle gives rise to lateral roots only. Vascular bundles are diarch to hexarch, that is 2 to 6 in number. Vascular bundles are polyarch, that is more than 6 in number. Cambium develops at the time of secondary growth. Cambium is absent, so no secondary growth. Pith is small and inconspicuous. Pith is large and well developed. Dicot stem, monocot stem. Ground tissue is differentiated into cortex, pericycle and pith. Ground tissue is not differentiated. Polenchymatous hypodermis, sclerenchymatous hypodermis. Single layered endodermis, endodermis absent. Pericycle made up of parenchymatous and or sclerenchymatous cells. Pericycle absent. Vascular bundles are uniform in size, arranged in a ring, conjoint and open. Bundle sheath absent. Phloem parenchyma present. Water containing cavity is absent. Vascular bundles are larger towards center and smaller towards periphery. Scattered, conjoint and closed. Bundle sheath present, phloem parenchyma absent, water containing cavity is present. Dicot stem, मोनोकॉट स्टेम, पिथ दैट इज मेडुला मेड अप ऑफ पैरेन्काइमेटस सेल्स एंड इज सिचुएटेड इन द सेंटर, पिथ इज एब्सेंट, मेडुलरी रेज फाउंड इन बिटवीन द वैस्कुलर बंडल्स, मेडुलरी रेज एब्सेंट, स्टीली इज यूस्टीली दैट इज कॉन्जॉइंट कोलैटरल ओपन, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर अरेंज्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रिंग, स्टीली इज अटैक्ड स्टीली दैट इज कॉन्जॉइंट कोलैटरल क्लोज्ड, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर स्कैटर्ड इन ग्राउंड टिश्यू, डाइकॉट लीफ मोनोकॉट लीफ, डॉर्सीवेंट्रल लीफ आइसोबाइलेट्रल लीफ, स्टोमाटा आर यूजली मोर इन नंबर टूवर्ड्स लोअर एपिडर्मिस, स्टोमाटा आर इक्वल इन नंबर ऑन लोअर एंड अपर एपिडर्मिस, मेसोफिल इज डिफरेंशिएटेड इन पैलिसेट टिश्यू एंड स्पॉन्जी टिश्यू, मेसोफिल इज नॉट डिफरेंशिएटेड, बुलीफॉर्म सेल्स एब्सेंट, बुलीफॉर्म सेल्स प्रेजेंट इन ग्रासेस, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स डिफर इन साइज ड्यू टू रेटिकुलेट वेनेशन, वैस्कुलर बंडल्स आर नियरली सिमिलर इन साइज ड्यू टू पैरेलल वेनेशन, प्राइमरी ग्रोथ इंक्रीज इन वर्टिकल एंड हॉरिजॉन्टल लेंथ और हाइट ऑफ प्लांट बाय द एक्टिविटी ऑफ प्राइमरी मेरिस्टेम दैट इज एपिकल मेरिस्टेम, रूट एपिकल मेरिस्टेम एंड शूट एपिकल मेरिस्टेम एंड इंटरकैलरी मेरिस्टेम, सेल्स ऑफ प्राइमरी मेरिस्टेम डिवाइड एंड एड न्यू सेल्स इन प्लांट बॉडी विच गेट डिफरेंशिएटेड इन प्राइमरी परमानेंट टिश्यूज लाइक पैरेन्काइमा पोलेन्काइमा स्क्लेरेन्काइमा प्राइमरी जाइलम प्राइमरी फ्लोएम एंड प्राइमरी मेडुलरी रेज, दस इंक्रीजिंग द हाइट और लेंथ ऑफ प्लांट्स, सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ इंक्रीज इन गर्थ और विड्थ और सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ बेसिकली डाइकॉट रूट डाइकॉट स्टेम रूट एंड स्टेम ऑफ जिम्नोस्पर्म बाई द एक्टिविटी ऑफ सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम दैट इज वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम एंड कॉर्क कैम्बियम, सेल्स ऑफ सेकेंडरी मेरिस्टेम डिवाइड एंड एड सेल्स इन द प्लांट पार्ट्स विच गेट रीडिफरेंशिएटेड टू फॉर्म सेकेंडरी परमानेंट टिश्यूज, वैस्कुलर कैम्बियम दैट इज इंट्रास्टिलार कैम्बियम produces secondary xylem, secondary phloem and secondary medullary rays, whereas cork cambium that is extrastellar cambium produces cork that is phloem and secondary cortex that is phloderm. Primary growth occurs in all kinds of plants and plant parts, whereas secondary growth absent in monocot root and stem, dicot and monocot leaf, pteridophytes, bryophytes, etc. Vascular cambium is partially secondary in origin and cork cambium is completely secondary in origin in dicot stem. Vascular cambium as well as cork cambium are completely secondary in origin in dicot root. Cork cambium also called phelogen. Secondary growth in dicot stem. Formation and activity of vascular cambium that is intrastellar cambium. During secondary growth, cells of primary medullary rays present parallel or adjoining to the intrafascicular cambium get de-differentiated forming interfascicular cambium. Next, a circular ring of vascular cambium is formed by joining of intrafascicular cambium that is primary in origin and interfascicular cambium that is secondary in origin. Intrafascicular cambium is present between vascular tissues that is xylem and phloem or within vascular bundle, whereas interfascicular cambium is present between vascular bundles. Secondary growth in dicot stem. Ring of vascular cambium has two components or two different cells. Fusiform initials, more in number, elongated pointed cells produce secondary xylem and secondary phloem. Ray initials less in number, oval, spherical or round cells produce secondary medullary rays. Fusiform initials divide periglimally and add cells both on outer side and inner side. Cells added outer side of vascular cambium redifferentiated in secondary phloem and cells added inner side redifferentiated into secondary xylem. Secondary growth in dicotic stem. Ray initials add cells of secondary medullary rays both outer side and inner side of vascular cambium. Redifferentiation of cells into secondary xylem occurs in the influence of auxin. Vascular cambium is more active towards inner side, adds more secondary xylem as compared to secondary phloem. 8 to 10 times more secondary xylem are added as compared to secondary phloem. Secondary growth in dicotic stem. Secondary xylem is added above primary xylem and below vascular cambium. Secondary phloem added below primary phloem and above vascular cambium. Secondary medullary rays added above and below vascular cambium and is present parallelly throughout secondary xylem and secondary phloem. Due to addition of secondary xylem and secondary phloem, primary xylem and primary phloem shifted away from each other, which were initially present close to each other. Secondary growth in dicotic stem. Due to addition of more secondary xylem, primary phloem and initially added secondary phloem get crushed. Only recently added secondary phloem remain present. More or less primary xylem also remain intact in the center. Due to addition of more secondary xylem towards center, soon pressure exerted over tissues or layers present outside the secondary xylem and these layers start shifting outward, which results in increase in girth of dicotic stem called secondary growth. Secondary growth in dicotic stem. Recently formed or produced secondary phloem and secondary xylem always present near to the vascular cambium. Secondary xylem also called as wood. If we consider activity of vascular cambium for 3 years, then secondary phloem of first year will be outer side, followed by secondary phloem of second year below it, and secondary phloem of third year will be present just above the vascular cambium. Similarly, secondary xylem of first year will be present in center, above which secondary xylem of second year and just below the vascular cambium, secondary xylem of first year will be present. Activity of vascular cambium in temperate region with reference to secondary xylem or wood. Activity of vascular cambium in temperate region is not same throughout the year. During favorable condition or spring season or summer season, more amount of secondary xylem are added. Vessels will have broad lumen. Components of secondary xylem will be less dense and secondary xylem appears light in color. Such type of secondary xylem or wood called early wood or spring wood or summer wood. In temperate region, during unfavorable condition or winter season or autumn season, less amount of secondary xylem is added. Vessels have narrow lumen. Components of secondary xylem are more dense and secondary xylem that is wood appears dark in color. Such type of wood is called late wood, winter wood or autumn wood. Annual growth, increase in girth or width in 1 year called annual growth. Annual ring or growth ring is equal to 1 spring wood plus 1 autumn wood. Dendrochronology, dealing with finding the age of tree by counting annual rings of old basal part of stem. In tropical region, seashore region, coastal region and desert region, there is no distinct annual ring formation. Plants of India also do not have distinct annual rings except plants of Himalayan regions like Shimla and Nainital. Annual rings formation is also absent in root. Shifting of activity of vascular cambium is fast from autumn wood to spring wood and vice versa. Heartwood, that is duramen wood, represent secondary xylem present in the center of old stem. Heartwood represents initially added secondary xylem, that is oldest secondary xylem having deposition of alkaloid, gums, aromatic compounds, tannins, flavonoids, terpenes, resins, essential oil in the lumen of vessels and tracheids. Heartwood is dead, non-functional and highly resistant with antiseptic nature. Heartwood is not involved in water conduction but has commercial value. Heartwood is durable and long living. Sapwood or alburnum wood represents secondary xylem present at periphery of old stem. Represents recently or newly added secondary xylem. There is no deposition of any compound in the lumen of vessels and tracheids. Wood is living, functional and sensitive for pests and pathogens. Sapwood is short living and has no commercial value. Heartwood is dark in color whereas sapwood is light in color. Tylosis or tracheal plugs, balloon like ingrowth of xylem parenchyma in the lumen of vessels blocking the transport of water called tylosis. Tylosis found in vessels of heartwood. As activity of vascular cambium continues to add secondary xylem, amount of heartwood keeps on increasing due to conversion of oldest sapwood into heartwood and amount of sapwood more or less remain stable or same. Manogyalic wood has less amount of parenchyma in secondary xylem, also called loose wood, for example cycas. Pycnogyalic wood has more amount of parenchyma in secondary xylem found in most of the plants, mainly conifers like pinus. Homogylous or non-porous wood, vessels are absent. 95% of secondary xylem is tracheids and 5% is fibers, also called soft wood, for example gymnosperm. Heterogylous or porous wood, vessels are present, also called hardwood, for example angiosperm. Ring porous wood, found in temperate region plants. Vessels have broad lumen in secondary xylem of spring season and narrow lumen in secondary xylem of autumn season, for example Dalbergia, Cassia. Diffuse porous wood, found in tropical region plants. represents asymmetrical wood. Throughout secondary xylem, vessels have same lumen. For example, syzygium, azadirachta, that is neem. Most durable and commercially useful wood is Tectona grandis, that is teak or sagwan. Secondary growth in dicot stem. Formation and activity of cork cambium. It also represents secondary growth in extrastellar region. Due to continuous activity of vascular cambium, more and more secondary xylems are added. This results in shifting of layers outwards, which soon cause slough off or peeling out of outer protective layer of dicot stem, thus exposing inner living tissues for pathogens. So need is must to add additional protective layers at the place of peeled layers. Secondary growth in dicot stem. Formation and activity of cork cambium. The function of adding additional protective layers is performed by meristematic tissue that develops into extrastellar region called cork cambium or phellogen. Cork cambium develops from outer layer of germinal cortex or sometimes from hypodermis by dedifferentiation process, where differentiated parenchymatous cells of germinal cortex gain ability to divide. Secondary growth in dicot stem. Formation and activity of cork cambium. Cork cambium can be one or few layers thick, made up of thin-walled, pointed or rectangular cells. Cork cambium is complete secondary in origin. Cork cambium divides periclinally and adds parenchymatous cells both on outer side and inner side. Parenchymatous cells added outer side soon get suberized and form cork, that is phloem. Parenchymatous cells added inner side remain parenchymatous and form secondary cortex, that is phloem. Secondary growth in dicot stem. Formation and activity of cork cambium. Cork cambium is more active outer side, producing more cork. Cork, that is phloem, cork cambium, that is phloem, and secondary cortex, that is phloem, are collectively called as periderm. Cork is suberized, water impermeable, protective layer. Cork cambium, also called extrastellar cambium, which performs increase in girth outside the pericycle. Bark. It is a non-technical term used for all the layers present outside the vascular cambium, include secondary phloem, primary phloem, pericycle, endodermis, general cortex, and periderm. Ring bark, that is seed bark, represents complete sheet of bark present in the form of ring formed by activity of continuous cork cambium. For example, bhojpatra, that is betula, and eucalyptus. Scale bark, that is fragment bark, represents discontinuous fragmented bark broken into fragments formed by activity of discontinuous cork cambium. For example, guava, that is cedium, neem, and mango. Bark formed early in the growing season called early bark, and bark formed late in the growing season called late bark. Lenticels, lens shaped pore present in the bark or cork of old woody stem. formed due to uneven activity of cork cambium outer side. Sometimes, instead of subarized cork cells, cork cambium produces compactly arranged parenchymatous cells called complementary cells, results in formation of pores, that is lenticels. Secondary growth in dicot root, formation and activity of vascular cambium. During secondary growth, firstly, conjunctive cells present below primary phloem get de-differentiated and form curved strips of vascular cambium below primary phloem. Now next, cells of pericycle present above protoxylem get de-differentiated and form strips of vascular cambium above the protoxylem. Strips of vascular cambium present below primary phloem and above protoxylem join together to form wavy cambium ring. Secondary growth in dicot root, formation and activity of vascular cambium. In dicot root, more part of vascular cambium formed by conjunctive tissue and only small part of vascular cambium formed by pericycle. In dicot root, vascular cambium is complete secondary in origin. Function of parts of vascular cambium present below primary phloem start soon, which add more secondary xylem inner side. This causes raising of curved part of vascular cambium outwards, results in formation of circular cambium ring. Secondary growth in dicot root, formation and activity of vascular cambium. Activity of vascular cambium in dicot root is similar to vascular cambium of dicot stem, that is addition of more secondary xylem inner side and less secondary phloem outer side. Vascular cambium also produces parenchymatous secondary medullary rays in dicot root. Due to addition of more secondary xylem inner side, the outer layers start shifting outward, results in increase in girth called secondary growth. Secondary growth in dicot root. As there is no seasonal variation below the ground, thus activity of vascular cambium remain constant throughout the secondary growth, producing same kind of secondary xylem, that is wood. Formation and activity of cork cambium. In dicot root, cork cambium is formed by pericycle cells. Here, pericycle cells are responsible for formation of complete ring of cork cambium. Secondary growth in dicot root, formation and activity of cork cambium. Cork cambium divides pericleanly to produce subarized cork cells above itself and below endodermis, whereas parenchymatous secondary cortex below itself and above pericycle. During secondary growth in dicot root, epiblema, general cortex and endodermis get slow off. Anomalous or abnormal secondary growth. Due to absence of formation of cambium, there is no secondary growth in monocot plants. Exception: Dracaena, yucca, palm, date palm, coconut palm, sansevieria, smilax, kingia, agave, aloe, etc. are monocot plants that show increase in girth called anomalous secondary growth. Palm, tulip, banana, that is musa, have special apical meristem called apical thickening meristem that performs both primary and secondary growth.